Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of 5-Minute Frenzy with Ryan Gapinski. Today's episode is part 2 on the Introduction to Invasive Ventilation series, where today we're going to talk about modes of mechanical ventilation. Before we talk about modes of ventilation, let's talk about the two triggers. When we talk about volume versus pressure, it is really similar to Marvel versus DC. They each have their own place. You would not expect to see Captain America in Gotham City, just as you would not expect to see Superman outside of Metropolis. The key to remember when talking about volume versus pressure regulation is that this is what's going to make the ventilator stop giving a breath. With pressure control ventilation, the ventilator will deliver each breath until it reaches a set pressure in the circuit. The tidal volume may vary with each breath. Therefore, it's important to set alarms related to tidal volume or minute volume to ensure that the patient is being adequately ventilated. With volume control ventilation is the exact opposite. The ventilator will deliver each breath until it delivers a set tidal volume. The pressure required to deliver the set volume may vary with each breath. So for this mode, it's important to set alarms related to peak inspiratory pressure in order to avoid barotrauma. Pressure-regulated volume control is kind of the best of both worlds, if you will. The desired tidal volume is set along with an upper PIP limit, and the ventilator will attempt to administer the entire tidal volume at the lowest pressure possible without exceeding the set PIP limit. One of the major disadvantages to PRVC is that it takes a few breaths to reach the set tidal volume. Therefore, if the patient is being suctioned or coughs a lot or otherwise fights with the ventilator, he or she is not going to consistently be getting the set tidal volume. Conversely, in a patient with an acute lung injury or ARDS who is sedated and paralyzed, this is arguably the gold standard. There is really only 4 modes of ventilation that you need to be familiar with at the entry level. The first one that I want to talk about is controlled or CMV ventilation. This was the first type of ventilator to come out and is the most basic. I mean, we're talking pumpkin spice latte basic. In this mode, the ventilator will deliver a set volume or pressure at a set rate, and that's it. Patients cannot initiate additional breaths, and in fact, on the first ventilators that came out, the inspiratory circuit would actually close between breaths. This is obviously not the case today, but nonetheless, this mode should only ever be used on patients who are paralyzed and sedated. Assist control ventilation was the fix to the CMV problem of patients not being able to trigger breaths. In this mode, the ventilator is set to deliver a set number of breaths per minute at a set volume or pressure. In addition to that, the patient can initiate a breath at any time, and the ventilator will assist the patient with a full breath. The problem here is that the vent may be set for 12 breaths a minute, and the patient is breathing an additional 4, 6, or even 8 times above what is set, and they're getting a full breath with each respiration. This can in turn lower blood carbon dioxide levels and create a respiratory alkalosis. Additionally, if the patient were to trigger a breath just prior to a regularly scheduled breath, the ventilator could deliver both of those breaths in succession, which can lead to breath stacking and barotrauma. The next mode to come out was a intermittent mandatory ventilation, or IMV. The concept here was to fix the problems between CMV and assist control. The ventilator will deliver a preset volume or pressure at a preset rate, but this time, between ventilations, the patient can take unassisted breaths. While this does relieve some of the apprehension problems in awake patients, it does not fix the problem with breath stacking. As you can see from the graphic on your screen, this patient takes 2 unassisted breaths, followed by a 3rd breath that is delivered by the ventilator. The patient then takes another unassisted breath. However, during exhalation, the ventilator kicks in and delivers a full preset breath. So the computer gurus and biomechanical engineers got together and came up with a solution. What they came up with is synchronized intermittent mandatory ventilation, or SIMV, a mode that you're probably familiar with. With SIMV, the clinician sets a mandatory rate and tidal volume or pressure. The patient can take unassisted breaths between mandatory breaths. But now, if the vent senses that a spontaneous respiration occurs close enough to the time that a mandatory respiration should be delivered, it will assist the spontaneous respiration and forego the mandatory one. If a spontaneous effort is not close enough in time to a mandatory breath, it will not be assisted. A mandatory breath, however, will be delivered at the set time, whether or not there is any inspiratory effort. As you can see in this graphic, the first breath was assisted by the ventilator. The second breath was not close enough to a scheduled mandatory breath and was unassisted. And the third breath was initiated by the ventilator. Guys, that's all I have for you today. As always, I hope this little snippet was helpful. I look forward to getting some more 5-Minute Frenzy videos out to you soon. And in the meantime, please feel free to drop me a line on Twitter, @RyanGapinski2, and I'll talk to you all again real soon.